Welcome to Vertiv. In Vertiv, we provide solution to grant the continuity to the data center business. Let's start from a real solution, a real situation in a data center room. On the left, we have the cold containment. In the cold containment, we have the front side of the server where we need to provide the right amount of air at the right temperature. In the room, we see on the right our air conditioning unit. LiberPDX have to provide the right amount of air at the right temperature and the right humidity inside the cold containment room. In the cold containment, it's very important to avoid to have recirculation air, to have hotspot. We need to have a stable condition of temperature and humidity on all the server. The PDX work with the hot air coming back from the cold containment in the hot situation of the room. Then they cool the air and they provide the air to the server, blowing and putting under pressure the floor, the raised floor. The temperature in front of the server is in the range between 22 to 25 or 26 Celsius, but can be different based on the server that any customer would adopt. Depending by the supply temperature, there is also the return temperature that can be from 30 to 40 Celsius. We understand that this wide range of temperature that there are inside the data center is a strong requirement for the air conditioning unit and for the components inside the unit. The evaporating temperature is really challenging because it can be up to 18, 20, 25 Celsius. And also the if we think to the system, because obviously the air conditioning direct expansion unit has an air condenser on the roof or anyway in the external ambient, we have also there a high variation of temperature from minus 30 to plus 55 ideally. To manage properly the functionality of the system, the indoor unit needs to be connected to the outdoor unit to have always the possibility to work in the better point. The capacity inside the data center is continually changing, and so the modulation of the direct expansion unit is a key point. Capacity modulation in data center is not constant due to three main aspects. The first one is the capacity planning. Capacity planning is not simple. Depend by how the server are working and how many server we are putting inside the room. Then we have the capacity utilization, because server are designed to have 10 megawatt of load, but customer put the server inside the room step by step. The last point that is really important for our business is the redundancy. If we have 100 kilowatt required, we cannot give 100 kilowatt of cooling. According to Uptime Institute, we see that both for power and for thermal, the majority of the data center have a step of redundancy from n plus 1, n plus 2, 2n, depending by the specification of the customer. What does this mean? It means that if we consider that n represents the thermal load inside the data center and r the redundancy, n is the number of units that we need to satisfy the load. R is the number of additional units that we put. In this way, if we have 100 kilowatt of requirement and we have the situation where we put exactly two units, 50 kilowatt each. So we max exactly the thermal load of the data center. This is the situation that we call N. Then there is the situation N plus one. So the load is satisfied by two units, but we put an additional unit. So we have three units that to satisfy 100 kilowatt are not working at their nominal capacity, that is 50 kilowatt, but at 33 kilowatt. So we see that the units are working in a partial mode. So we need modulation inside the unit to grant this functionality. Last point is when we have N plus 2, or 2N in this case. The capacity is lower than the previous case because we have four units running, so each unit can run to 25 kilowatt. What is the impact of this? If we consider a failure of one unit that can happen for different reasons, we see that in the cases with N, we miss capacity because we have two units of 50 kilowatt each, one is failed, we have just 50 kilowatt available. In the situation N plus one, if one unit fail, we have the other two units that in the emergency can grant the capacity. Same in the situation N plus two. One unit failure is not influencing the data center. We see that the capacity of the unit is not constant, is changing due to the data center, first of all, but also in the various step of how the system is working or in case of any alarm failure that can happen to the system.
Thank you, Giorgio, and welcome everybody here in front of our brand new Liberty PDX with a variable speed compressor. This unit specifically is a PI074. To give you some idea, it's about less than 2 meter long and is less than 2 meter 8, and it can provide more than 70 kilowatt of cooling capacity. This is part of a wider range because the Liberty PDX with a variable speed compressor range from 15 to 120 kilowatt of cooling capacity. And this unit in particular has a frontal air delivery. This means that the air comes in from the top and the air delivery is frontally from this grill on the front of the unit. This unit is also a double circuit unit. Let's understand together what this means. You have here on the left side the fixed speed compressor. Instead, on the right side, you have the variable speed compressor. As said, with this product, we have introduced this new technology, variable speed compressor, in our floor mount range. The benefit of these technologies are many and different, but among them, we can identify some core benefit, and they are mainly the improved efficiency, both annual efficiency, but also the max load efficiency. They are the reduced current, because we have reduced startup current, and we will see later the benefit, reduced noise, and also improved reliability, because inverter compressor are not subject to frequent on-off cycle, and therefore this reduces the wear of the component. But variable speed compressors are not the only innovation we have introduced in this new range of product. During the development of the range, we have focused on four core values. These values are efficiency, cooling continuity, flexibility, and smart control. I want to explain you for each of these values how we have achieved a top level in each of them. Regarding efficiency, what we have done? We have used, as said, variable speed compressor, but also electronic expansion valve as standard and EC fan for the evaporator size. but we have also improved the minimal modulation for these components. Our compressor can modulate down to 20-25% of the maximum capacity, and our fan can modulate down to 30% of the maximum speed. All of these combined together has allowed us to achieve a top level efficiency, both nominal and both annual and partial load. Regarding another benefit, cooling continuity, our unit Liber PDX can handle a power outage in a really efficient and rapid way. We have in the electrical panel available an option to handle a double power source, and when the power is back on the second line, our unit can restart with a fast start. It means that in less than 35 seconds, we can have the unit running again at full capacity. But regarding cooling continuity, we have also other software features to improve the continuity that are the management of redundant sensor and also the management of fault of sensors. It means that if any sensor on the unit have a fault, we can handle this event. Another benefit is the flexibility. Regarding flexibility, as mentioned before, the unit must adapt to a wide range of outdoor temperatures and also return temperatures. Our unit can work with a return temperature up to 40 degrees, and the outdoor temperature of the air entering in the heat rejection condenser can go up to 55 degrees, but also down to minus 30, and this means that our unit can adapt to really extreme environment. Speaking about the flexibility, we have available four different types of airflow configuration. This unit, as said, has a frontal air delivery, but we have also available upflow configuration, that is that air enters from the bottom and goes out from the top, but also downflow configuration, downflow up or down. That means that the air is delivered on the raised floor, and fans can be or out or in the raised floor. Last but not least, regarding flexibility, our unit can work with a maximum equivalent distance between indoor unit and condenser of up to 100 meters. And this without any problem and without complete peace of mind about the efficiency, granted cooling continuity, and also about the reliability of compressor, because you will not face any problem linked to this long distance to the compressor. Last but not least, we want to speak about our new ICOM control, our new smart ICOM control. Thanks to this new control, we have introduced an innovative 7-inch touchscreen display that can be even replicated in a web browser. But we have also introduced new features to guarantee cooling continuity, as we already mentioned. We can manage also, for example, fan failure. If any of the fan fails, we can handle this failure thanks to our new control. Moreover, we can handle also failure on the heat rejection condensers. Thanks to our new control, we can manage from the indoor unit both the indoor unit and the outdoor unit. And this allows us to exploit the full envelope of the variable speed compressor from in all the modulation range. So this allows really to exploit in a full way the benefit of the variable speed compressor. In conclusion, our new range of PDX with the variable speed compressors matches exactly the requirement of the new generation of data centers, mainly those on which the load can vary very rapidly, instantly, I would say, like the one for cloud computing. But not only, our LibrePDX can adapt to all data center configuration and can match the very strict target for efficiency and cooling continuity required in our market. Thanks again for the attention, and if you have any question, we are available for you.